Zhang Sanfeng is famous in China because he invented the world-famous martial art known as Tai Chi. There are countless legends about this man. He was described in Lewis Cha's best-selling novels, The Heaven's Sword and Dragon Saber, and Return of the Condor Heroes. But his birthplace remained a mystery. There are at least 30 different places that claim to be his birthplace. His hometown and early life remained unknown. When a book of genealogy was discovered in Heping of Fujian Province in 2008, the truth about Zhang's background began to surface. The historic town of Heping is nestled in the mountains of northern Fujian, 120 kilometers from Wuyi Mountain. It was built over 1,700 years ago in the Tang Dynasty. Its main street is paved with bluestones and cobblestones and stretches 600 meters from south to north. Around it, lanes form a maze among the nearly 300 Ming and Qing Dynasty homes. Looking down on the town, there are only a few newly renovated buildings among the lines of old houses. One holds the records of the story of Zhang Sanfeng.
Have
you heard
of Zhang Sanfeng? No. I've
Many villagers don't know about Zhang Sanfeng or the genealogy book. Could it be a false lead? Sixty-six-year-old Fu Huanmin is the former curator of Shaowu Museum. He's done research on the relationship between Zhang Sanfeng and Heping. Zhang Guangrong brings out a wooden box containing the genealogy book. Historic records from the late Qing Dynasty state Zhang Zichong, born in the Ming Dynasty, was styled Sanfeng and nicknamed the Sloppy. Perhaps Zhang the Sloppy is the great martial arts master.
张三丰呢，他的真正的正名是叫恭后去逢臣，他后来脱离这个凡世间，不过世俗的生活了，与翠云庵修炼数载，在翠云庵上修炼了好多年，忽然白日升天，脱凡于旧市虚伪神仙桥，旧市虚就是我们的和平镇，和平古镇。
Legend has it that Zhang Sanfeng lived over 400 years. Two Ming emperors would search in vain to find him and the secret of immortality. Yet such a figure was granted only a few lines in his clan's genealogy. It seems the famous master Zhang Sanfeng didn't fit in his hometown. Many of the historic relics indicate Heping was a literary town. This is Heping, home of the Grandmaster. A clan forum is underway in the Shangguan Ancestral Hall near Kanxia Village. Heping was once known as a town of scholars. It produced 134 successful candidates in the imperial examination. 76 came from the Shangguan clan. In Heping and the Shangguan family, orthodoxy was seen as the way to achieve ideals and pursue honor. Among the many mansions in Heping, the Huang clan's is among the most impressive. It features upturned eaves and elaborate interlocking wooden brackets. The rich brick carvings indicate the social status of the family. Huang Zhizhong was born here and can usually be found hanging around in front of the mansion. He still relishes the family's past glory. The man is happy to show the Huang clan's private college. Like the Shangguan clan, the Huang also encouraged their children to pursue fame and high rank through education. When the local people did succeed, they built a home in the shape of an official's hat, with carvings bearing lucky sayings. Zhang Sanfeng, however, was seen as a rebellious figure. More detective work is needed to determine what kind of person Zhang was. Zhang Guangrong goes to a well behind the village, the well of the immortal soul.
为什么叫仙人井呢？这条井我们姓张的，难道这里来挑水也可以，酒也可以？如果是外姓的来到这里来挑，如果要就要酒就要跟那个铜板下去，你要有一只呢，就是张三丰的母亲，就是给张三丰讲，他讲人有酒喝，那个猪没有酒糟，所以第二天他这个井里面就熟起来，你看那个酒糟，你要就没有酒就了。能尝尝呢？
可以，这真正的天然的矿泉水，
没有受到任何污染的。
怎么样？甜的，是吗？嗯，味道好极了。没有酒味，是水味。<laughs> 现在是没有酒味了，它已经不是酒了。扔钱进去变成酒，这不会了。It's
not known if this well ever produced liquor, but the villagers called it the Well of the Immortal. It seems people changed their view of Zhang Sanfeng. Zhang Sanfeng once meditated in the Cuiyun convent in these cloud-covered mountains. If the Zhang clan is right, the traces hidden in these mountains might give more credibility to the claim that Zhang Sanfeng was born in Heping. The summer heat makes it difficult to trek among the mountains. At Liaoshan Peak, there's an unexpected discovery. A temple built in the Tang Dynasty occupies a unique location. A cliff looms behind it. In a small cave, an expert from Shaowu Museum is making rubbings. It's an exciting discovery. The discovery proves that Zhang Sanfeng visited Liaoshan Peak. Perhaps it's another clue that will reveal the truth. The tea trees by the road are ragged, but their leaves have a magical function. It would seem impossible that ordinary tea leaves could help a person chew metal. The route to Suiyan Peak follows a narrow path paved with mountain rocks. It leads to a stone gate. Because of this route, Heping was among the first places in Fujian to embrace central Chinese culture. Technology, literature, and philosophy from the central plains were introduced. An old saying goes, Fujian has 8 prefectures and Shushan is their ancestor. Shushan refers to the mountains behind Wuyang Peak. Before long, a rock cliff with signs of being chiseled appears by the road. This old cliff is overgrown, and the characters on it are barely recognizable.
Here,
This, at least, proves that Zhang Sanfeng was in Heping. At the peak, the bare ground is a stark contrast to the forest below.
这个地方啊，就是传说中的张三丰炼丹的地方。就这一大片。啊，这一片，你看这边跟其他地方不一样，它这个土质的颜色跟其他地方不一样。你其他地方这个土质是黄土，这里整个都是白的。据说呢，是因为他炼丹啊，很多丹药什么的留在这个地方，所以它这个地方呢，土色也变了。
Toxic materials such as sulfuric acid and mercury were used to make elixirs. If some spilled, it would taint the soil and prevent vegetation from growing. Perhaps Zhang Sanfeng really did make elixirs here. There's a connection between golden tofu and Zhang Sanfeng. And do tea leaves really help you chew copper? This is Heping, home of the Grand Master. Huang and his son are ready to start making their second round of golden tofu. It's only 7 o'clock, and the first batch of tofu they made late at night is already sold out. Golden tofu has been popular in Heping for centuries. Huang's family has been doing this for generations.
Hello.
Huang Donghua learned how to make tofu from his father and is now very skilled. This handmade tofu is sold to local restaurants and customers, as well as people from other places. Tourists like to give the popular tofu a try. Huang's tofu is considered the best.
黄豆腐是用那个草药，那个我们山上黄栀子的果实去熬成水，熬成水再放豆腐进去煮，就成黄色。你小的时候爱吃豆腐吗？天天守在这个豆腐房里。哎，
还吃到现在为止，两天割不了豆腐。
As Huang skillfully makes the tofu, it gives off an appetizing aroma. Others want to try making it as well. Huang runs the family tofu business, but he doesn't know much about the origin of golden tofu. It's said that long ago the local people used plaster as a coagulant for the tofu. This created health problems. Zhang Sanfeng suggested people use the bean curd residues as a coagulant. The tofu made in this manner was called golden tofu. Then there's the story of the copper-breaking tea leaves. A woman performs the trick.
Come on. 真的能碎铜吗？
真的
真的。
那会不会把牙碎掉啊？
不会。
那他能把铜板这么硬的碎掉？那牙齿，那有铜板硬吗？还得嚼一嚼。
先嚼一嚼，他这个时候不能说话。
对。
乾隆通宝，声音还很清脆。放一颗还是放两颗？
放一个。好，谢谢。
傅老师，给我记下时间吧，看看多久能碎掉。
It seems unlikely the tea leaves can break copper.
可以了吗？
可以。
时间？
3分18秒。
OK。
可以看一下奇迹。
见证奇迹的事。
哎呦天！
The copper breaks apart in just 3 minutes. It's time for some first-hand investigation.
碎成几大块？
好几遍。
这样，我试试啊。
不急，慢慢的。
慢慢嚼。
Unfortunately, nothing happens.
Okay. 不骗我们吧。
明显听到的声音。
听到声音，对呀。
咬到。碎了，现在碎了。是多少时间？
才1分33秒啊。
也好多了，
高手。哇。
不可思议啊。不可思议。它为什么能碎铜？其实有一个定论没有？
没有一个能够让任何部门任何人都信服的这样的一个结论。说法很多。
跟张三丰有关系吗？
这个倒是从传说上说有。据说呢是张三丰在那边练功，由他点化。还有的说法呢是说，很可能是张三丰当时这个在那边，练功的时候呢，他形成的那个气场。
The connection between Heping Town and Zhang Sanfeng is clear. It's also clear why Zhang's descendants refused to honor him despite his fame. The family viewed him as a maverick. These days, the former black sheep is the pride of the town.The legend of Zhang Sanfeng adds an aura of mystery to Heping. It's believed that Zhang Sanfeng left Shaowu in his early 20s. He traveled around China and finally went to Mount Wudang to create Taichi.He became a great master of Taoism and martial arts. There's an unbreakable bond between Heping and Zhang Sanfeng.